Hey everyone, so I posted earlier wanting to know everybody's opinion on fat shaming. It's something that is a normal term that you hear all the time, and it's so funny, it's not funny, but so many people will feel so strongly about this that it's wrong. And you know, I've seen fat shaming and it's horrible. I've also felt like I've been fit shamed and it's horrible. The biggest thing is so many people fear being judged because they themselves judge. But I really want to focus on helping more people have a positive body image, because I know that I suffered from very low self-esteem and a really poor body image at a young age, and it's not something that goes away. It gets worse. And I'm seeing now that people in our generation have been so focused on perfection that they have so much negative voices in their head that manifests in their behaviors and even out loud, and it's starting to really trickle down to the next generation. I've shared before that I've seen pictures that my daughter has posted of her friends who were not overweight at all, but they left comments on Instagram saying, you know, take that down, you know, I look fat, or cover my stomach up. And you see so many pictures of people when they're posting stuff that they're hiding behind other people, they're covering their stomachs up, they're, you know, because they're so afraid of being fat shamed. And so I want to really bring up a subject that so many people feel so strongly about, being fat shamed or seeing fat shaming, but they aren't cognizant of what's going on in their life or their head. Like, body negative body, you know, images, or you know, or manifest in your head. Like, you don't realize it, but if you want to change it, it really starts with identifying these things that you say. You know, I hear it all the time, and I've said it myself, like, oh, I wish I was, you know, that weight, or, oh, you know, I haven't been that weight since, you know, before I had kids, or, oh, well, you know, she looks way cuter than I do. And, you know, we live in a world where comparison is so easy because of social media. But really, if you want to beat this, you really need to focus on these things that are your triggers. So one of the things that I noticed as I've been thinking about this last couple days is, and I used it as one of my goals that I shared with my challengers, because they run monthly groups every month, and we just discuss different various things. And today I asked everybody to set goals for the week, or just focusing on 7 days at a time, not getting ahead of ourselves, and it's nothing that's tied to numbers. But my goal was to stop checking the mirror looking at my stretch marks. That's something that has bothered me ever since I had my daughter, and she's almost 18. And I'm learning to just embrace it, because I mean, like, I know men and women who have stretch marks, you know, and it's normal. But there's so much of a perception, you know, socially, to be perfect, and there's, you know, magazines with these flawless looking people that aren't really right, aren't really reality. But my goal was not to do that, and to be more aware of what I was doing. And I can count 6 times today that I looked at my stretch marks. Every time I go in to go to the bathroom, I drink like a gallon of water a day. There's this mirror in front of me, and as I'm pulling up my shirt to pull my pants down, sorry TMI, I was looking in this mirror, and I always like look, like, I don't even know what I'm looking for, but like, I'll squeeze my skin, like my extra skin that I have from having kids. I don't even know what I'm doing, but it's this habit. We became very aware of it today. Every time I walk by my TV, you can see my reflection well. Well, I walked by it and I pulled up my shirt and looked at my abs and my stomach and then squeezed my extra skin. And I was just like, I caught myself, because I told myself that I was going to be more aware of this. I'm like, what the fuck are you doing? Like, why are you doing that? Like, what do you think would change between an hour and the next hour? But these are the things that I'm trying to be more aware of, because these are the things that, you know, lie in the back of my head. And there's this voice there that is nasty and ugly. And so this is something that I'm becoming more aware of. And so the mirror is somewhere where every minute you look in the mirror, instantly negative stuff comes back. And you have to really focus on your trigger. Like, what is it when you're looking in the mirror that you're looking for that sets off? For me, it's like, I pull up my shirt, look at my abs, I'm like, oh, it's so disgusting, I have stretch marks and extra skin. I wish, and you know, I start wishing things that I could have that aren't possible, and it's just a waste of my time and energy. So you know, now I need to just change that, because if I'm going to look in the mirror, I need to be looking for something that I am proud of. And you know, today when I caught myself looking in the reflection of the TV, and then I was like, oh, my legs look killer, like, and so I focused on that. So it's really about just being aware of your thoughts, replacing it with something else, and you know, just training your brain. And you know, I share this with other people because I share so much about my life, and people, I always get these comments about like, oh, you're so lucky. Oh, I wish I had your motivation. Or, you know, oh, everybody seems to think that it's easier for me than somebody else. And I get it. I never knew anybody who is fit. I never knew anybody who was successful. And so I always assume that somebody had the upper hand than, you know, and that they were more prone to being successful than they had it easier. So I share these things because like, I have the same issues. Like I have body, you know, issues still, and I'm working on combating that. And really, you know, when you do these things repeatedly and you don't get it in check, it becomes your identity, and it becomes something that eats away at everything. Like everything that you do is dictated by that negative voice in your head. And so, you know, if you're somebody out there that, you know, comment on my post today about that you hate fat shaming, and then you're, you know, it just makes you livid, and then it's just ridiculous and nobody should be shamed. I really ask you though, do you apply that to yourself? Because we ourselves are so critical, and we are nastier to ourselves than anybody else. And that is what really causes other people to lash out at others. I see it on social media, the trolls, the icky comments, the haters. It's usually the people that feel so horrible about themselves because they're judging other people and they're worried about being judged, and it just creates this nasty energy that just spews out. And so all I can do is encourage you and share with you what I'm doing to improve that. And just, I want you to understand that that voice in your head that's pointing out the flaws in your body also is dictating what you do in general, as a mom, as a wife, as an employee, just as a human being. There's so many people who aren't living because that negative voice in their head is telling them that they're a loser, that they can't do it, they're too fat, they're too this, and these are limiting beliefs that, you know, you can do anything and you deserve everything, but you have to believe that. And that's one thing that I posted about today that my success partner and I talked about. She said, you know, how do you get people to love themselves? I know that I can't make you love yourself, but I can share with you my story of how I didn't love myself and how I'm learning still to love myself, and share with you the steps that I'm taking so that you can see that real human beings can do it. It's not hopeless. You're valuable, you're worthy, and you deserve and are capable of amazing things. But it all starts, you know, it's like in your head. It all starts in your head and what you believe. And all I can do is hope that I can breathe some life into your mind and the way you think so that you can go out and explore more and actually truly live your life instead of hiding behind people or staying in your house. But you can have full control of your life and you can change the world with your story. And so I hope that I can help you. And if you have any questions, let me know. I'm here always to listen.